dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science station. So as we know, yesterday we have started our new lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Getting to know plants. So in that already we have discussed about the classification of the plants, how on the basis of their size and the type of the state, the plants are categorized into three parts, that are herbs, shrubs and trees. So in today's session we will move for the next point from the same lesson, that is we will discuss about the parts of plants. So my dear student, this is not a new concept for you. From the third standard you are watching or you are learning these concepts, that is what, parts of the plants, okay. But in this case or in this today's lesson, we are going to see deeply all the parts of the plants, how their modification, how they are, what is their function, all these things we are going to discuss, okay. So let's see, here I am having my plant. So according to these plants, we will discuss the different parts of a plant. So if we talk about the plants are getting divided into two main parts or two main systems, that are root system and shoot system. Okay, the plants are divided into two systems, that are root system and the shoot system. So root system is what? Obviously it will relate to the root. Okay, or we can say that the part of the plant or the part system of the plants which is underground or that we cannot see, which is under the surface of the soil, that system is called as what? Root system. Next one, the part of a plant which is above the ground, which bears the fruit, flower, leaves, bud, okay, all these things are present on the system, and that system is called as what? Shoot system. Okay, so on the shoot system there are different things are present, and for that only we can call them as what? Different parts of a plant. Okay, so see here, I am having this plant. According to this plant we will discuss the different parts. Before that I can say, I'll tell you that the part which you can see now, that whole portion of the plant, it is called as what? Shoot system. It is called as what? Shoot system. And next one, the part of a plant which is underground, that you cannot see, that part of a plant, it is called as what? Root system. Okay, so on the shoot there are the different other organs of the plants are present, different other parts of the plants are present, that we will discuss now. Okay, so see here, I will tell you one by one. So this part of the plant which is above the ground, it is called as what? Stem. So these stems are having different branches. You can see here, this is the branch, this one is the branch. So like that, so many branches are present on the plant. Next one, we will discuss that. Here you can see the leaves are there, okay, different leaves are there, although so many leaves are present, that is also the one part of a plant. Next one, you can see here the fruit of the plant, okay, it is what? The fruit of the plant. And also you can see the one flower is also there, that is what? One part of the plant, okay. So you can see these are the different parts of a plant. We can say that what? Stem is there. Next one is what? Branches are there, okay, this is also one branch, this one is also branch. Here also you can see here are the two branches are there, okay. So this is the one part of a plant. These are the different leaves, these are the certain leaves which are present on the plant. Also we can say this is what? Fruit. It is also the one part of a plant. Here is the flower, that is also the part of the plant. And here are the certain buds are there, okay. That bud is also the part of a plant. I think so you are unable to see this bud, but here it is, the one bud is present, that is also the one part of a plant, okay. So these are the different parts of a plant, and this each part we are going to see deeply one by one. So now today we are going to see the first system of the plant, that is about what? Root system, okay. So the basically the root systems are again having the two types. There are the two types of the roots, that are taproot and fibrous root, okay. So what is mean by the root system? The part of a plant which is under the ground and that we cannot see, that part of a plant, it is called as what? Root system. It is called as what? Root system. This root system always grows towards the gravity, okay. It grows towards the gravity and also it grows towards the moisture and helps the plant to make the further life process. So in short we can say that this root system always grows towards the gravity and the moisture, and also it grows away from the light, okay. It also grows away from the light and also always grows under the ground. So there are the two types of the roots that are taproot and the fibrous roots. Okay. So as we know, the germination process is there. So after the germination process, the radicals comes out and the radicals get converts into the root system. So in some plants, the seed after germination brings out, or the one single root is coming out from the seed. Here you can see that one single root is coming out from the seed. Okay, from the seed one single root is coming out, and along with that root, so many small side roots are also comes out. Okay, so that roots are called like the roots which grows side on that main root. Okay, that it is called as what? Side roots or the lateral roots, or also it is called as what? Root hair. Okay, this root basically thicker at the beginning or at the main point where it starts, it is the thicker, and as we go downward, at the downside it is what? Taper. Okay, at the downward it is the taper. It is having the so many side roots are there which are called as what? Root hair or the lateral roots or the side roots. Okay? So this is the main root, that main roots brings out or the forms the so many side roots which are called as lateral roots or the secondary roots also we are calling it. Okay, so this type of the root which is thicker in the beginning or upper portion and the taper at the downward portion which are having the lateral roots in all the direction, then that type of the root is called as what? Tap root. Okay, it called as what? Tap root. Basically this tap root system we can say into the big trees like that neem, cashew nut, jackfruit, all these trees are having the tap root system. Now we will discuss the next one, that is what? Fibrous root. So in some plants the roots bring, or there is a bunch of the hair like or the fiber like roots. Okay, there is a bunch of the fiber like roots, and that bunch is only called as which type of the roots? That is what? Fibrous roots. So there is not one primary root is there. There is only the one group of the roots which looks almost like a fibers. Okay, here you can see that so many spine roots are there. Okay, and that type of the roots are only called as what? Fibrous roots. So these fibrous roots basically grows from the base of the plant. Okay, from the base of the plant, and it forms the one bunch of the fiber like structure, and that roots are called as what? Fibrous roots. So these fibrous roots we can mainly see into the cereal crops and into the grass. Okay, so the grass and the cereal crops are having the fibrous roots. For example, we can say that wheat, jowar, bajra, and different grasses, all these grasses are having this fibrous root system. Okay, so here we have seen the taproot and the fibrous roots. Okay, now we'll move for the next one, that is what? Functions of root. Okay, what are the functions of the root? The first one we are going to discuss about what? Fixation. So as we know, the plants helps, or the plants are standing upside straight into the soil. How? With the help of these roots. So these roots helps to hold the plants tightly into the soil, and with the help of the roots the plants can stand properly above the ground. Okay, so in this way fixation is the main function of the root. It fixes the plants into the soil and protect them from the storms and other natural calamities. Next one we will discuss, that is what? Absorption. Now absorption means what? The roots helps to absorb the water and the minerals from the soil and transport it to the different parts of a plant, and from that different parts of a plant it is useful, or it get used for the further activities like what? For the photosynthesis process. Okay, so from the roots absorbs the water and minerals from the soil and it transported to the stem, and from the stem it gets transported to the remaining parts of a plant. Okay, so from the root it goes into the stem, from the stem it reaches to the different parts of the plant. So this is the next function of the root, that is what? Absorption. And next one is what? Prevent soil erosion. So as well, if we plant more and more trees, then we can decrease the soil erosion. So how it is possible? So as we know, the roots holds the soil tightly and it fixes the plant into the soil. Okay, so these roots hold the soil very tightly, so it can help to prevent the soil erosion. If there will be the flood, then very less amount of the soil will run away with the water.
there are the plants. Why? Because the plants' roots are there which hold the soil very tightly and fix the plant into the soil. So in this way the roots of the plant also helps to prevent the soil erosion. This way these all are the functions of the roots. So today we have discussed about the parts of plant. There are the two parts of our plants, that are root system and the shoot system. In that we have started the root system. Roots are having two types, tap root and the fibrous roots. And also we have discussed about the functions of roots. What are the functions of the roots? Fixation, absorption and prevent soil erosion. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.